Good morning, students. Today we will start our next point. See, in the last lecture we started a new lesson, that is element, compound and mixture. So before to start the actual element, compound and mixture, some basic point, that is the classification of matter, that we are discussing. So today we will see the next point in the classification of matter. See, in last lecture we have discussed about the states of matter. Okay, there are three states of matter: solid, liquid and gaseous states. Okay, so now we will learn the next point, that is interconversion of matter. Now interconversion of matter means what? See, these also you are learning from fourth standard, means one state to another state, then another state to next state, means it is the interconversion of matter. It's related to their states, means what? The solid to liquid, liquid to gas. Okay, these is only the interconversion of matter. So what is the exactly interconversion of matter? Here I written the definition, that is the phenomena of change of one state. See here, the change of one state of matter into another state. Okay, and it back to its original state, means after some times it comes into its original state, that is only the known as a interconversion of matter. See, yesterday I have sent you one diagram. Okay, this is the diagram, that is the interconversion of matter, and maybe you have drawn also. So what exactly it is given here? See, the first basic we will see. Suppose in this beaker water is there. Okay, water is in which state? Liquid state. But when you will provide heat to this liquid, see, first this water is in which state? Liquid state. Okay, when you will provide heat to this liquid, after some times it start to convert into steam, means this water will convert into gaseous state. Okay, this gaseous state. So here the liquid is converted into gaseous state, so this is also the interconversion of matter. And while condensation process, now condensation process means what? This water vapors convert into a liquid state, water droplets. That process is known as a condensation, means when you will stop the heat, so this steam, it will convert into a water vapor. That process is known as a condensation. Okay, so these are only the interconversion of states of matter. See, here the diagram is shown. This is the solid, and see the molecular arrangement in the solid, they are closely packed to each other. Okay, while melting process, now while melting process, so this solid, suppose for example ice. Okay, what we will take the example? Ice. While melting process, this ice is converted into water. Okay, here example we will see, that is water. Then see the molecular arrangement, here it is a loosely packed. Why? Because this ice is converted into water. Okay, then see this water, when you will give heat, then it will become a gaseous, means water vapors, vaporization process. Which process? This is a vaporization process. See, yeah, now first we are discussing about this solid. This first is a melting process, means any ice, when ice will get the more temperature. See, in a freezer there is a temperature less. Okay, and you know that water is converted into ice at 0 degree Celsius. So when you will keep that ice outside, it will start melting. So melting process, it convert into liquid, and that liquid, if you will give the heat, then it convert into a water vapor, and that is in which state? Water vapor, gaseous state, and that process is known as a vaporization, or you can say it is the evaporation also. Okay, and then see, this gas again it converted into a liquid state that is known as a condensation. Okay, so melting, condensation, vaporization, evaporation, that all the process we learn before also. And now the one more step it is there, that is the sublimation. Now sublimation means what? See, sublimation, solid substance directly converted into a gaseous state. It will not convert in a liquid state. That substance are known as a sublimable substances. Then for example, which is an example, see camphor. Okay, it is one example of the sublimable substance. Means camphor is directly converted into gaseous state. So that is one example of sublimable substance. So these only the interconversion of states of matter. Okay, write this all the points in your chemistry notebook. Next point we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.